Parthaya. Pratibodhitam Bhagavata Narayanena Swayam Vyasena Grathitam Purana Munina Matte Mahabharatam Advaita Amrita Barshinim Bhagavatim Ashtadashadhyayinim Ambatvam Anusandadhami Bhagavad Gita Bhavaddeshinim Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsa Charnu Ramardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Bande Jagat Gurum We were studying that Raja Yoga this in the ninth chapter, and we will today we'll study from the 21st verse. Now we have already seen that here again and again very clearly it has been mentioned, as it is in the Hindu the religion, the rebirth, and rebirth according to the karma, and that goes to the subtle body. And we have three bodies: gross body, then subtle body, then the causal body. Causal body has nothing to do with this too, and mainly the subtle body and the gross body, they are working. We are very much aware about the gross body. We know what is happening every day, every moment. But at the same time, we are a little bit aware about the subtle body too. And in the subtle body, the main, there are many together is in the body. Main is the mind. And mind is the place where we accumulate all the impressions, and it goes. Now the God is teaching us that if you are training your mind, preparing your mind in such a way so that you will think only about the God, not of the world, then you are free. But there are also gradations also there. The people who are trying to get the God realization or to develop the spiritual life sometimes do not understand what actually it is. So different variation that we are studying. We have already studied up to 20. Today, let us chant 21 words. Tetam bhuktva sargalokam vishalam shine punne Martalokam Vishanti Evam Trai Dharma Anuprapanya Gata Gatam Kama Kama Labhante Tetam bhuktva. So te tvam bhuktva. What is that te and tam? That which we have already performed. So that karma phala, that result of the karma. So they, tvam bhuktva. So when they already have passed their or spent their karma phala, what happened? Sarga lokam vishalam. They are talking about those people who went to the swarga loka. Now majority of the people, their goal after death is the heaven. To go to heaven. Here in the Hinduism they say that is also a temporary place, just like this place. That is also a temporary place because that is not the original. Unless and until we go back to the source, the original, so again and again we have to take birth and die. This circle will go on. The swarga lokam vishanti, who Trai vidya mam soma paputa papa. In 20th verse they said Trai vidya, the in the Veda, the three Vedas are there. In those Vedas, whatever the injunctions have been given, after following that, performing that, then they also take the soma paputa papa. They are free from all the sin. What is that soma? Sometimes we say the charanamrit, that is that. After worshipping the whole puja, then we worship or wash the holy feet of the god mentally, and then we drink that little water that purifies our body. So naturally people, they go always for that particular type of liquid. So that if you are drinking, you think you are becoming, and that's true, you are completely free from all the sin, then you go to swarga. What is that swarga? According to your choice, according to your desire, it's a good place, better place, and you'll be there. But that is also temporary. Why? Because you have earned it. Whatever we have earned is temporary. Good merit or bad, whatever, temporary. So one gentleman came, he was in a very good position, then something happened, he made a mistake, then he was arrested, he was put in behind the jail, then he was in the jail. After again he has come out, again he is writing the books, and so he went to, because of the bad karma, he went and he suffered and come back, again normal life. Again, whatever the work he is doing accordingly, he will get that result. It goes on. In our this life also we are seeing. So many people, because of some reason, they will go to jail. Again, afterwards they will come out. Like this it happened. Similarly, when we are doing the good work, we go to swarga according to the God's rule. Then when you go to the swarga, the heaven, there also, whatever the good work we have done, that exhaust, then we have to come back. Te tam te punyam asadya surendra loka asnanta divyan divi deva bhogan. After bhogan, after enjoying that, coming back, where te tam bhuktva. Bhuktva means after enjoying those things, sarga lokam vishalam, the vast swarga world, having enjoyed. Then what happened? Shine punne. Ya punya, with the merit, it becomes thin. The balance is not there. So you come back. Shine punne, where they come? Martalokam vishanti. This is the martaloka. So they come back to this martaloka. Evam tri dharma anuprapanya. Gata gatam kama kama lavante. Now one idea is there, it becomes like a drop of water. Ultimately, when all the karma phalas are over, we are coming back, maybe from after all the sins are over, again taking birth, all the good merits are over, again taking birth, that time the soul, it takes a form of a drop of water, and it falls somewhere, and then, and through the any body, maybe it's a human body or the animal body, the bird's body, accordingly, according to the karma, it takes the birth. But one Upanishad, it is very clear, Shvetashvatara Upanishad, it says that it goes through the food into the body of a male and then it takes the birth slowly. That particular food, this soul is choosing. Now there is a doubt. They say, if I can choose that, I will always go to the good people. Even though I was not supposed to take birth in a good family, but if I have the option, if I can choose, I will go to that food which is going to be eaten by a good person. I can be his son. So that argument, they say no. At that time, how it happens, then they're giving the example. Suppose a man going up, climbing a tree. That time he is conscious. And he climbed on the top branch and then fell suddenly. When he was falling down, he was not having any control. He was not having any control where he will fall. It is just like that. When you are going to Swarga, when you are going to heaven, and then you are falling down, at that moment when you are falling down, you are not conscious where you are going. There is no chance of choosing. So according to your karma phala, it will automatically go. And they will drop, etc. The tetam bhuktva sargalokam vishalam. The swargaloka is a very big and vast, and enjoy for a long time. Shine punne. Now, why the long time? Again, they say, in the particular in the Purana, because one circle is over. Suppose you have done very good work, you become the associate of God or demigod, you have lot of power, you are living in the heaven, and that continues for a long, long time. Not that today I go and then come back next day, not like that. They will be there, and then, you know, even if you are in a very good situation, after some time, you feel starting bored. Oh, why I am here? Let me go somewhere else. It's just like that. So you become satisfied living in the Swarga, and then the desire comes to move somewhere. Let me go and check and see what are the other places. He was in a very nice place, very comfortable, but still that desire comes. So this we know, this we feel, this is our regular, experience. When we are someplace, somewhere, we like to go to a foreign country. When you go to that foreign country after living there, some other place. So we are not satisfied. So some people, they'll be living in Chicago, a good place. After some time, oh no, it is very cold. And look at this, even in October itself, it is snowing. So let me go to Southern California. Southern California you go, then suddenly it's burning, all the houses are burning. Oh my God, let me go some other place. So every time you go, something happens, you become dissatisfied, you move. So similarly, after even reaching over there in the Swarga, you become satisfied completely and say, start dissatisfying. No, this is not, let me go somewhere else. That craving again pull you down. So when the mukti comes, again and again they say, and we must remember, the complete cessation of desire, isn't it? Again and again, almost all the scriptures are telling, complete cessation of desire. No desire at all. Good and bad, these two are completely gone. That won't be there. Ashtavakra Gita that we are studying, and also Avadhuta, again and again you will find, Avadhuta is very clear. He said, I don't find any difference. What is good and what is bad? I don't find any difference. So obviously, the mind is completely satisfied, and that is called mukti. So here you have to come back. Evam tri dharma anuprapanya gatagatam kama kama labhanti. So because of the desire, they constantly go on this changing. After coming over here, again the work, again desire, it goes on. Then in the 22nd verse it says, but ananyas chintayanto mam ye jana paryupasate tesham nityabhiyuktanam yoga shemam bahamyaham. So when we read the 20 and 21 verse, it become really some, maybe we start thinking, oh my God, then what is going to happen? What is the end? Where is the end and how to get that end? Then in the 22nd verse, Bhagavan immediately, so we should not lose our hope, Bhagavan is telling, but those who are constantly thinking, me, the God, who is all-pervading and having all this different form, this universe is my creation, but I am not this universe. Those who understand this, so when they are living in, even in the creation, they are constantly thinking of me and constantly thinking. Ananyas chintayanto mam, non-separate, ananya, non-separate. They can never become separate from me. When they see the sun is rising, their mind would automatically say, oh, look at God's power, the beautiful scenario in the morning. When the sun setting, the same thing. God has created this beauty. They always associate it. They never go for the natural beauty, this, that, never. Always at the back, only God. Once Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna's direct disciple, Ramakrishnanandaji, he was walking with some devotees, and that time sun was setting. In the big field, almost in the horizon, where the sun was setting, you can understand, it's a beautiful the scenario. And they were praising, oh, beautiful nature, look at this, look at that. Then the Swami turned to them and he said, why don't you think about the person who has created this? You are thinking and appreciating the creation. Can't you ever think about the creator? Ananyas chintayanto mam. So that is the reason when the Brahmins, the traditional Brahmins and the traditional Hindus, before even taking a sip of water, they will say, oh God, then, oh Vishnu, then they will drink. The water is Vishnu. And the person who is drinking is a Vishnu. So everything that is happening, this God's. Ananyas chintayanto mam, constantly. Some people make it a habit and just like a habit they will go on, not like that. Like a parrot they will go on telling, no, not like, truly you are feeling. When you are going to bed, thinking like that. When you are drinking the water or taking the food, thinking in that way. Ananyas chinta, that the word ananya, never ever separated from God. The ananyas chintayanto mam, meditating, ye jana paryupasate, this is worshipping me, upasate, upasana, upasana means worship, paryupasate, tesham, for them, nitya abhiyuktanam, and they are regularly, constantly, every moment, they are associated with me, what I do, yoga, shemam bahamam. This is a great word. Yoga and shema. Yoga means Whatever is necessary for that particular person, everything God will provide. And not only that, as long as those things are required by Him, that will be protected by the God. They will always get it. The Ma Sharadamani Devi, when she prayed for the monastic children of the Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, after the passing away of the Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, all his monastic disciples, all young people, from 18 to 24, that was the age group, what they will do? There is no food, no shelter. Most of them, they used to wander here and there. In India, if you go to any holy place, and you will get some food and the shelter for the monks. It is all free. So they used to roam like that. The mother didn't like it because the Sri Ramakrishna brought a unique light, a philosophy for this modern society. So she prayed to Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna. She said in this way, O Thakur, O God, you came, you displayed, and then you went back. Everything is over? No, it should not be. Please bless this your children so that they can stay in one place, and the devotees all around, they will come and provide them whatever is necessary for them, and also get the good advices. These people will live a holy life, and the devotees who are in the mundane life, they will come, they will support them and listen from them how to develop the life. And in that, when they are living in the household, how to be detached from there and come to you. The God realization. That was the prayer. So Ananyas Chinta, from then onwards, whoever has come out taking the name of Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, not only he is well protected by somehow. At the same time, his family is also taken care. This is really very, very peculiar. Many of our Swamis who were only son, when they decided to become the monk, then who will look after the father and the mother? But somehow everything was arranged. They were also happy. So this is the way it goes on. Yoga Shemam Bahamaham. The yoga and shema, they will always do. In my personal life also I have seen, when I went to Assam for relief work, in a very remote corner, and one gentleman, he dropped us over there. That is also a long story. But we were not having any food. For any reason, we were not getting any food. What to do? Then the tea shopkeeper was there. I told the brother, can you please boil some rice for us? Because you have the oven. When your all work is over, can you please boil little water? Then we can put the rice and can have the... And little, if the rice is there, all other things we'll manage. And then we can eat the rice. Whole day we used to work. And working means walking knee-deep water. And we're constantly working over here and there. Sometimes it just goes to neck deep. You have to work in this way. And when you come back, soaked in that dirty water, and then no food. Only food that we are having, the tea from that shopkeeper, the tea shop, and some braids, that's all, from them, him. We used to put that bread into that tea and then eat. That was the food. And after 2 days, I understood that it will be very difficult. Two brahmachari, another senior swami, myself. I was wondering what to do. Shall I contact the headquarters or go back? When I was thinking in that way, suddenly one gentleman came and he said, the just opposite, we were in a guest government guest house, and opposite there is a family and one young lady, newly married lady, and she was from Guwahati and she knew Bengali, she knew Ramakrishna Mission, and she has invited us. So we went and she told, having her father-in-law and the mother-in-law by her side, she told the Swamiji, the mother is telling the mother-in-law that you have come to serve our people and you have come from God's house and you are not having food. It cannot be. We will cook food for you if you please accept. Can you imagine? If this is not miracle, then what is miracle? Ananas chintayanto mam. Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, and jokingly, he himself is God, but he used to jokingly used to say, some people brought some sweets. Then he told the devotees, see, I take the name of God, so all these things come. So he was very happy. So, ananas chintayanto mam. Ye yana pariyupasate tesham nitya abhiyuktanam. So here we have to have the faith in the words of God. When there is a desire in your mind as a monk for the betterment of the society and for the betterment of many people, without ego, know that the God's will manifesting through your thought, and have the faith God is going to provide everything. Just you have to have the effort, that's all. Whatever is necessary, you must try. And all things will go on coming. Yoga shemam bahamaham. So it's going on. And the next verse says, yapyanya devata bhakta yajante sraddhayannitaha tepi mame bakonteya yajanta vidipurvakam aham hi sarvayajnanam bhokta cha prabhureva cha natu mam abhijananti tatve natascha bantite. 23rd and 24th, those devotees who are with a saddha, with that faith is there, that this is a very important thing. I do not know exactly what God is, but I have a Shraddha. What is a Shraddha? Respect. What is the respect? Respect in the words of Guru and also the teachings of the scripture. So I have understood this much. So when the scripture is telling that there is God, and God can be realized, and for the realization, you must do like this and this and this. In the Bhagavad Gita itself, in the 12th chapter, is very clearly mentioned, I like those people who are having this quality. 16th chapter, from 1 to 3, these three are the verses, 26 qualities, if you should develop these qualities. How to develop? Then Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna and many other great souls, they are teaching, go to the holy people. Who can be considered as a holy people? One who is not having any desire and having full love for each and every one without any discrimination. If he loves only, or she loves only her own people, those who are his or her belonging to that particular philosophy, religion, culture, and language, no. He'll have the broad idea to accept each and everyone because of the love. If that is there, is a good man. Go to him, sadhu sangha, listen to him, and see how he has developed his life. follow that. So this is the way the God directly and sometimes through Mahapurusha, sometimes the great soul, spiritual soul, giving the teaching. If you develop that, you will get, but the basis is Shraddha. Shankaracharya describing the Shraddha, Shastreshu, Guru Vakyeshu, Shatya Buddhi Abodharanam. Satya Buddhi, this is the truth. Since our Gospel of Sri Ramakrishna again and again is the greatest Shastra scripture, because it is the words of the realized person. And it says God is there. You can see God. You can talk to God. So we have to have the faith. So it says when you are Shraddhanita, if you are worshipping some other gods and goddesses, Yajante Anya Devata, those devotees who are worshipping the other gods with Shraddha, with the respect, they too worship me alone. Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna is explaining here, when a little baby, the baby boy, he is calling the papa, can't pronounce papa perfectly, some sound he is making, but the papa knows that he is calling me. The papa will never say, oh no, you can't call me properly, so I am not going to accept you. Not like that. Papa knows. Why? Love is there. Faith is there. Dependence is there. So if the father can understand in this way, the father of the world won't understand. He will also. So when we cannot pronounce the name properly, we do not understand which is good, but I have a great devotion. So here we can tell us that wonderful story, very famous story. Our Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was listening to Bhagavad Gita and someone else was explaining, reading and explaining. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was sitting. Another person was also sitting nearby. He was looking at the book and going on shedding tears, crying. After this reading was over, Chaitanya Dev asked that man, "Sir, have you understood what he was explaining?" "No, sir, I couldn't." "Then how come that you were crying?" "Well, no, I see the picture on the book and the Bhagavad Gita on the top, the cover, there is a picture. Sri Krishna, he is the chariot, he is driving the chariot. Arjuna is sitting. It should be the other way. The disciple should serve the master. Here the master is serving the disciple." So seeing the compassion of God, he is ready to do anything. If you only have faith in him, I could not control my tears. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu embraced him and said, "You have understood Bhagavad Gita." This is called Shraddha. This completely understanding thing with a faith, unshakable faith. And where it goes, this devotion to me, the God, the Supreme Being, all-pervading consciousness. Then the 24th verse, "Aham hi sarva yajnanam bhokta cha prabhureva cha." This is me who is in everything. Bhokta cha, I am the enjoyer and the lord of all yajnas. But because they do not know me in reality, they return to the mortal world. The two existences are there. One, the creator. Second, his creation. Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna again and again used that, the magician and its magic. And sometimes, if you can find even in the YouTube, the great magicians. The magicians is having his own world. There will be so many varieties of things, and also his the helpers. So that is the magician's world. then he will create so many different things, beautiful flowers, and the pigeons are coming out, this is happening, that is happening, so many things. All those things are temporary and false. Who is real magician? That is exactly what Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna is telling. So we have to go to the magician, not to his creation, which is completely magic, not real. So we have to understand that way, that God has also created this universe, and he has created in such a way, not only he has created all the objects, he has given a desire inside our mind, and the desire is popped up through our ego. I like this, I like that, I do not like, I do not do this. All that from the ego is generating. So the I is so strong in every individual. It's very difficult to overcome. Very, very difficult. So many people, they came to become monk in the Ramakrishna mission, I have seen. And afterwards, slowly they developed the ego. And then finally they had to leave. Again back to this world. Why? That's ego. And why this happened? Again and again, people are asking Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna in the gospel of Sri Ramakrishna. And he said, Mahamayar Leela. This is the divine play of the Mahamaya. And in the olden days, there was a special type of game. One person will sit in the center, and around him there will be a circle, another circle, and another circle, three circles. And each circle will be guarded by one person. So one or two persons will be guarding the circle, first circle, the bigger one, then the second one, then the third one. Then this person is sitting, it's called Budi, the center. Now you, the other group, they have to somehow come inside this. The first line of people, you have to dodge them and come in. So you are in between the first line and second line. And second line guards will try to touch you. Then you have to also somehow, if you can jump. Then the third, then only you can come and touch the center person who is sitting, and he will say, okay, you are free. So you are free from the game. That was in the olden days, village boys, they used to play like that. Budi chhoa khela. So they used to play like that. Sri Ramakrishna from the village background, so he is quoting that and telling, but the center person who is the main doesn't like that everybody should come and touch him. Then the game is over. So the game should continue. So more you go closer to God, more the difficulties come. The ultimate difficulty is the ego. Because it is always with you. The ego is helping you to leave the household. No, I am going to become a monk. That is also ego. But that is forcing you to come out. Then this ego will say, now I have to do this japa. 1 lakh or 10,000 japa every day, and then the meditation, then the this, that is also there. Slowly the self-confidence, then comes the troubled times. Then when you are little settled over there, the people accept you as a holy person, they start coming to you, touching your feet, taking your blessings, and the ego which was sitting on your shoulder now start entering into you. All these days it was out. Now you say, okay. Through the touching, and then the ego comes. I am a great person. I can expound like this. I am very popular. People come to me like this. All this way it comes. So he is telling, it is, I am everything. Remember it. And if you can remember this, then there will be no problem. Aham hi sarva yajnanam bhokta cha prabhureva cha natumam avijananti. And when you do not understand that God is in everything, you make the mistake. Then he said, what happened? Different grades of people, not that everybody will be lost. So he is giving the gradation. Yanti deva brata devan.
Yanti deva brata devan.
Pitrin yanti pitri brataha. Bhutani yanti bhutejya.
Bhutani yanti bhutejya.
Yanti madyajino pimam. Now it says three different types. One, those who are worshipping the gods and goddesses. Another, the mains, purva purusha. And then finally, you have not gone, I don't know. I visited one place. It's a tantric's place. And there the people, lifelong they are doing the austerity only to have a soul, departed soul, the ghost under his control. I don't, what you are going to do with that? That will be terrible to control that the ghost. No, no. Through that power, we can do anything. Look at it. He is also practicing austerity. He is also living 24 hours over there. He is also taking the name of Goddess Kali. All these holy things that he is doing. Why? Only to control a ghost. That's all. You won't believe how courageous they are. Sometimes the poor people in our villages in India, they can't burn the whole body. And they will be doing a little mukhagni. They will put the fire in the mouth and then they will leave it. They bring the dead body. They make a place inside the earth. Then they will cover the earth. On that they will place their asana. And they will go on chanting the name so that the person below whose body has not been burned and he is going to catch the soul of that particular person. Where he will go? See, the Bhagavad Gita, Bhutani Yanti Bhutejya. So those who are having this type of, this is the 25th verse, it says, it happens like this. Even the those who are worshipping the devas, they go to deva. The many are there, many if you go, Sri Ramachandra, my god, and then this god, that god, Hanumanji, then these, and like that they will do. So only one god and they are not thinking of anything else. That particular god, why you are doing? So majority of the people, Hanumanji gives the success, he gives the protection, etc. So Hanumanji. Some people will be there, and you know, in South India, so many gods are goddesses, North India, so many, one god. Majority, some of the people, they are there, I worship only Goddess Durga, and also the Goddess Kali, they will also have that. So, not some total of that, not the complete consciousness that is all-pervading, and that consciousness only manifesting through this form and that form. That conception is not there. So devan. So they go to that particular god or goddess. So yanti deva brata devan. The votaries of the devas go to the devas. Then the pitris go to the to there. What is the pitri? Many families are there. They will worship only their ancestors and no one else. My mother was my goddess, so I'll worship my mother. Great love and attachment for the mother. But the conception is wrong. So mother, that particular figure, the affection that I got from that lady, that attachment, that makes me bound by that. And after the death, I will have that blessings only. So pitri, they go to that. Then bhutani yanti bhuteja. After that, there's the bhutas, the worshippers, they go to bhat. Finally, it comes to, it say, madhyaji no mam. So they come to me. This me is the aim capital, the god which is all-pervading consciousness. So when they are worshipping me, they come to me. How you have to worship? So now this next verse it says, so simple. Patram pushpam phalam toyam. Yo me bhakta prayachati. Tadaham bhaktu prahitam. Asnami prayatatmanaha. Is only devotion. A little flower, a fruit, little water, patram, pushpam, phalam. Pushpam means flower, phalam means the fruit, patram means the leaf, and also the toyam, the water. Yomi bhakta prayachati, but with devotion when you are giving. And the example is there in the Shabari. The Shabari, the old lady, she was having nothing but love and devotion and faith. When the Sri Ramchandra came, she heard that Ramchandra is the God, and she believed it. And how she worshipped Ramchandra? A little flower, only wild flowers. Then good type of leaves he collected with that, gave the water to drink, and the fruits, whatever she could collect. But God was so happy. Why? Devotion was there. So this devotion is the main. So they also come to me. So three, four types of people. One, those who are going to the devas. And those who are going to the mains. Those who are worshipping the ghost and all. And those who are worshipping me, understanding the me, that all-pervading God. So these are the four categories. And how to worship? Don't think about the materials. It is nothing. Only the love. Only the devotion. The best thing the God loves, Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna said, is your tears. Can you cry? Now he is telling, for those who are sincere, for them he is telling, yat karoshi yadashnasi, yat juhosi dadasi yat, yat tapasasi kaunteya, tat kurushva madarpanam. Shubha shubha phalai rebam. Moksha se karma bandhanai. Sanyasa yoga yuktatma. Bimukto mam upayushyasi. Yat karoshi yad asnasi yad juhoshi dadasi yat. This is the ultimate karma yoga. The karma yoga teaches that whatever you do, do with an attitude of dedication. Whatever I am doing for the Lord. Doing for the God. Don't wait for the appreciation of your boss or anyone. I am doing it for the God. So that much, nothing else. And whatever you are doing, so it says, whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you offer, and whatever the sacrifice, everything, even the austerity, that sometimes we are having the penance, like the fasting and all, or walking on the barefoot, whatever I do, at the end of the day, you have to offer it to God. God, whatever I have done, this is only for you. I don't want anything else. except you, nothing else. If you read Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, his biography, the great master, you will find that Sri Ramakrishna is praying to Mother. How he is praying? And if you read, then it, almost your tears will come out, the way he is telling. And if you could hear that, the voice, I don't know, the so divine. What he is telling? Mother, I don't want anything else. Don't give me physical comfort. Don't give me the name and fame. Don't give me anything else except you. I don't want anything else. So that is the reason sometimes they say this our scripture is little confusing, and different types of the different ways they are telling. And the great souls also describing in the Bhagavad Gita, so many people they are narrating Bhagavad Gita. The discourses on Bhagavad Gita, so many people all over the world. And then the Psalm people are also there, they themselves are reading and trying to understand. So the different meaning they are understanding. Then what should he do? Then it says, Mahapurusha yena gata sapanta. Try to follow the path of the great soul. Who are the great soul? Like Sri Ramakrishna. Just in the modern time, he came in our time and he lived in the village. He loved his parents and family, and he was so much attached to his family. He never left his family, but at the same time, he not only realized God, he showed that God can be in the human form again and again. So when he is praying to God, that is a demonstration, as a teaching for us. What should he request? What should he pray to God? Give me love for you and nothing else. Give me love for you and nothing else. So this way, if we can pray, so yat karoshi, yadasnasi, yajjuhosi, dadasi yat, tat tapasasi kaunteya, tat kurushya madarpanam. Everything that comes, that give it to me. Lord, I don't have anything except you. Please accept this. With a great devotion, if you give it to the God, and nicely go and sleep. My work is done. I have prayed. I don't know what will happen. It is up to you. I have worked. I have worshipped. I don't know what is going to happen. It is up to you. By that way, if you go to the God, God will take care, for sure. Next he is telling, Shubha Ashubha Phaloi Rebam. Shubha and Ashubha, from the good and evil result, this karma bandhanaihi, the bondage of action, bearing good and evil result, with the heart steadfast in yoga of renunciation and liberation, thou shalt come unto me. Now the work, yat karoshi, that means I am doing the kriya, the work. If I am doing good work, I am getting the merit. Doing bad work, then also the punishment. But I give both to this God. I don't know what is good and what is bad. Whatever the best way I thought, I have done. Now it is up to you. So this is the way, if you have given, what will happen? Then it says in this verse, in the 28th, good, bad, whatever the result of the action will come, everything will be taken care by me. The God will take care. Only thing you have to dedicate, everything you have to dedicate. So friends, I think if you have any question on this, then one or two questions we can have the answer. Or the next, how many verses are left? Three, four verses. I think in the next we will have that, in the next class. This is November. December will be our last class. Then there will be a recess for 2 months, January and February. So we will complete the ninth chapter and that. And again we will start from the March. So let us conclude, but if you have any question, because 2-3 minutes are still left, you can ask. That is all pervading supreme being. We call God, but it is beyond God. The God is a limited conception, but when it goes to each and everything, the me means all pervading consciousness, which has been expressed in the Isha Upanishad, Isha Vasham Idam Sarvam. Isha, the God, Vasyam, covering, Idam, this, Sarvam, everything. Everything is covered by God. This is a unique conception. So when we understand that, that we don't find fault with anything. Because the people who are doing wrong thing, bad thing, they're coming from God. And the other religious people, other faith or the philosophy, we cannot criticize them because God has given them that idea. Who am I to criticize? So when that happens, what develops in your mind? When you always think that everything that I see, a person who is praising me and helping me, a person who is criticizing me and creating problem for me, each and every one is nothing but the same manifestation of God. Then what happens in your mind? What thought will come? Love only. The pure love. You can never ever criticize others, think bad about others, and that is the ultimate of the religion. And when you go to that level, you merge with that consciousness, and it is not a part, it is the full. And when you go back to the full, there is no desire. So that is called ultimately the mukti. So that he is telling, they will come to me.
He means here Krishna is telling this Bhagavad Gita. So he is not in person as Krishna, but it is God.
Yes. It is not in person. That person when you look at and make it limited, that is the problem. It is that the Sri Krishna himself is telling in the that 11th chapter, when he is showing Vishwarupa to Arjuna, he is everywhere. He is everything. And the people who are taking birth and leaving, and they are also going back to him, he is almost crashing them. Each and everything is happening on him only. That is true Krishna. Then all these, the legs, the hands, the eyes, the head, everything is nothing but me. So that is Krishna. In the Purusha Suktam also they are describing everything is that. Sahasra Shirsha Purusha, Sahasraksha, Sahasrapad. Sahasra means unlimited, infinite. And Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, he said, Ishare iti kara jayana, that you cannot make the end of the God. God is like this or up to this, that you cannot do. Because it is unlimited. The moment you say God is only Krishna and no one else, you are criticizing God. But still, some good will happen to you. You will go to Krishna, you will listen to that beautiful flute, the music, you will have some joy. Again, after some time, you will think, oh, it is enough. Again, you have to come back. Because you are acquiring something. Or when it is that you are, then you are not acquiring. That the Atman, the Brahman, the all-pervading consciousness is not an object. It is always a subject. And that I am. When it comes to that level, so where is desire? What I am going to do? Nothing. An expression of that will come through two wonderful qualities, love and unselfishness. Expression of all-pervading consciousness comes through, in this world, love and unselfishness. These are the two. Okay then? Let us chant this mantra and conclude. Yam Brahma Burunendra Rudra Maruta Stinnanti Dibyai Stavai Vedai Sanga Padakramopanishadai Gayanti Yam Samagaha Dhyanavastita Tadgatena Manasa Pashyanti Yam Yogino Yasyantam Nabidu Surasuragana Devaya Tasmai Namaha Om Shanti 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 Hari Om.